George says, if you've been lucky enough to stumble across this plumberparts.co.uk video trying to find out about what to do when you're first turning your heating system on, then great, you're going to find out all the information you need in the next few seconds. But first, George would like to tell you to subscribe to our videos because we do lots of plumbing help every week. Don't we, George? Don't run away. Moody cat. Since George can't be bothered to talk to me, I hope you find out the information you need. And remember, everyone, to hold tight.
plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Hold tight and welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video. My name's James and today we're going to have a very quick look through the little checklist that you should do when you turn on your heating system for the first time after a balmy British summer of rain and sort of 20 degrees, you know, when it's just not very nice. The temperature outside at the moment's dropped down like below 0 degrees or whatever, and it is getting cold. So people are thinking about turning on their heating systems. If you're hard, you haven't turned it on yet, and you've just put another jumper on. If you're like me, you're thinking about whapping on your heating now, and this is basically a brief checklist of the things you should do. Anyway, I'm going to divide the checklist into two things. Firstly, just the really simple stuff that any kind of house owner or DIY can do with really simple tools. And then the slightly more advanced bit. Don't get me wrong, it's not really, really difficult, but you sort of need slightly a bit more knowledge or, you know, cojones to have a look at the certain things we're going to do. So firstly, let me just go over the really, really basic start bits. I hope you enjoy the video and I hope you subscribe and I hope that you hold tight. So number one on your list of things to do is to get yourself a little radiator bleed key like the one I've got here. There are a few different types, and just go around each one of your radiators in the house and bleed the air out of the top of the radiator. You're probably going to find usually that there's not a lot of air or there's none at all. I mean, that's brilliant. It means the heating system's been well inhibited, which is a treatment you put in the water to stop air happening. If you do have loads of air, might be a good idea to give your plumber a quick call once you've got all the heating working and just say, mate, can you pop around and whap some inhibitor in the heating system? Or you can click on the link that's appearing now that will show you how to put inhibitor in your heating system. We've also left a link to that in the description below. So the usual way to bleed a radiator is to make sure that both valves at each end of the radiator are fully open, and then grab your radiator bleed key and just open that, open the key up. You'll see which end it is. It's on the nice cross end here. Just open that up like that. And as you can see, we've got water coming out of here straight away. Once you've bled any air out of the radiator, the next thing you're going to need to do is get a pair of grips, remove the radiator TRV if you've got one, and then use the grips to wiggle the pin underneath the TRV and make sure that that's free. Once you've done that, go to the lockshield end, which is the other end of the TRV on the radiator, completely close the lockshield by turning it clockwise, and then give it half a turn to 3/4 of a turn anti-clockwise, and then that radiator is set up and ready to use. Do that to every radiator in the house, and then we can move on to the next little job you need to do before turning your heating system on. So once you've got that done, obviously, you know, if you're letting water or air out of the radiators, if you haven't got an F&E tank in the loft, which will automatically refill the heating system, then you're gonna need to use the filling loop on the boiler or on the pressurized kit to just top up the water level in the heating system. If you're not happy doing this bit, then get a plumber in for you. I mean, it is really, really easy, and I've left a link in the video description below as well as to how to pressurize a heating system as well using that method. So the next thing I'd do is go to your room thermostat. If you've got one like this, make sure it clicks. Yeah, clicky, click, click. So make sure that that's working. And then really we're at the end of the beginner's department, okay? You've gone around every radiator. You've effectively done a thing called balance the system, whereby you've shut down the lock shields and just cracked them open a little bit. What that does is evenly distribute flow throughout the whole heating system so all the radiators get nicely warm. We've made sure that the TRVs aren't stuck shut because sometimes they can be shut for the whole of the summer and then not spring on again. And also we've made sure that there's no air in the heating system. The next few things I'm going to show you are very, very simple. Before you turn the heating system on, it's very important that number one, you know that the pump has got water in it, if you can get to it, and also that the pump impeller inside is nice and free. And then secondly, if you've got any zone valves, either 2-port or 3-port valves, just use the lever arm on them to make sure that the valve body is completely free. I'll show you how to do those bits right now. Right, so it just so happens I've got a nice little pump like this just hanging about that I've taken out of an old house. A real old Grundfos this one is here, but most of the pumps are the same. A lot of the time now, the pumps are self-venting and you won't have a nut on the end of it like this. But if you've got a nut on the end of it like this one here, it can't hurt just to whip this nut off using a large slotted screwdriver like the one we've got here. You're going to get a little bit of water come out of here, so you might need a little towel or something like that. And then inside, you've got the actual end of the impeller. We pop our screwdriver in there, and as you can see, we can wiggle around the impeller on the inside. So now we know that the pump's going to be free and it isn't going to seize up and burn the pump out when we turn the power on. And all we do once we've done that is just pop our little nipple back on here and tighten that up. So the next and slightly more advanced thing as well, after we've looked at the pump, is to make sure that all the two port and three port valves are motoring okay. Really, really simple to do. You can either grab the lever on the end. Most different manufacturers of two port and three port valve have a motor on the end as well, so you can have a look at that. And if you really, really want to go into it, you can unscrew the little screw at the end, make sure all the power's off, of course, which it should be because we haven't turned the heating system on yet. And you've got a little screw in here that undoes, just like so. And you've got a little screw on the other side here that undoes. Then you'll be able to pull off the head without having to drain anything down. You can only do that, especially with these Honeywells, with a head that's got a dimple on it. But every other type of manufacturer, Drayton, Meyerson, Danfoss, there's loads of them. All of their heads can come off pretty much without having to drain anything down. And then you've got the actual valve body here. Just make sure that that's nice and free and easy to move as well. And there we go, that's lovely there. And we know that's working okay. And we know that the motor's working all right on here. Now, once you've done all those checks, I'd always advise that if you want to, pop half a tub of inhibitor in the heating system, make sure that's topped up. If you really want to go into things special, you can drain the system out and flush it all through and all that sort of thing. But really, for most DIYers, what we've just done there should be like by far like what you need to do to make sure the heating system's okay. Now, all you need to do is turn your thermostat right up, turn your programmer on to heating constant, and obviously turn the hot water on if that's on as well. And then you should find that the valve opens, the pump cuts in and works okay, and all the radiators get lovely and warm as well. So there we go. As if I was going to finish off a video without giving Mr. G a nice big gut scrub. I hope that video has given you a better idea of the small little checks you can run through to make sure that the heating system's going to be okay and make sure that it's going to work all right. Obviously, if you've got any problems or you need any more information, then contact us on the comments section below this video. Please share this video with your mates as well on Facebook and Twitter or wherever, where you can also follow us at our Facebook page. I'm leaving a link to that right now. And also there's a link to it in the description of the video below. So if you go through a quick run of what we've done there, we've made sure that all the radiators are working, that they're balanced out. We've made sure there's no air in the system. And if there is, we've topped the water up. And also we've put a little bit of inhibitor in as well if we needed to. We've made sure that our pump is not seized up and that it nicely runs and wheels around. And we've also made sure that the two port or three port valves that we were looking at, all the motors work okay and the valve bodies are free and clear, ready to use. Obviously, if you do find that you've got any problems, then call a qualified plumber in to come and sort it out for you. Don't try and do anything more than that if you're not happy doing it. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'll see you in our next video, which is an Ask the Plumber video with all the plumbing disasters that you guys send us in on a daily basis at our Facebook page. Remember, if you've got any photos or videos or anything like that, send them through to us for our perusal, and you never know, you might win a sticker and a scrub from Mr. G. Anyway, I'll see you in our next video. And remember, everyone, what are you going to do? You've got to hold tight. See you later.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Come here. Oh, George.